ABC News' Alex Pache is here to tell us more about the summit. Alex, president says the U.S. is all in on Africa's future and the digital economy they're building. Their U.S. foreign adversaries like China, Russia, they're already have deep economic political ties with Africa. The U.S. doesn't, never has. It's always, no matter what any president says, it's always been an afterthought or an after-afterthought. If I'm an African leader, why am I believing it's different now?
Well, you know, the White House is hopeful that these commitments of dollars behind the talk is going to be enough to prove that this is actually a real thing. You were talking about an investment in the region. Well, listen, I mean, we talk about the effects of the pandemic, and we talk about the effects of food supply shortages because of Russia's war with Ukraine. Well, that is compounded in the African continent. And so you see the president talk about shoring up not just things on that front, but also having digital infrastructure investments over the next few years. He's talking in the hundreds of billions of dollars range there. And look, I mean, you know, for them, it's a hope that, yes, this is the first U.S.-African leader summit since 2014, but with these dollar commitments, that this will show that, hey, there actually is more to the words this go around.
So there seems to be this sort of openness to an idea of closer ties. Money speaks. We'll see what happens. But there's also the talk about, hey, will the African Union join the G20? You've got South Africa. Will others join?
Well, so certainly, and right now, I mean, South Africa is the only member from the continent a part of the G20. But look, I mean, one of the big initiatives that the president announced today is an investment through Congress of over $350 million to facilitate over $450 million to finance financing for African lines within the African Union's digital transformation strategy. They're hoping that that is a huge carrot in this fight to essentially build relations in that region.
And Alex, have you got a sense from this summit of the openness of African leaders to this kind of overture? Look, China, we know, has had just this tremendous investment and presence in so many African countries. They're doing well by China. Have you got a sense whether or not this push by President Biden is going to have any payoff?
I think time will kind of tell. There's going to be a big dinner this evening where, you know, we'll get a little bit more of a read out on how this this three-day summit is going. But again, Terry, I mean, I think, you know, the stakes are relatively high here. You talked about China's investment already in the region, and there is a significant fear that if the U.S. doesn't specifically work on this relationship with the continent, it will further persuade these African nations to align themselves with not just China, but Russia and some of our other adversaries.
All right, Alex Pache, we'll follow the three-day summit for sure.